Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangan University, India. Today's topic is first lecture of discrete Fourier transform. We call this DFT. First, why do we need DFT? And also, let me explain time resolution and frequency resolution in DFT. Okay, first of all, let's recapitulate about this. Okay, continued time Fourier transform means this continued time signal. From this, we want to change time to frequency domain. We call this a continued time Fourier transform. And also, discrete time Fourier transform is this discrete time signal. From this, we want to change time to frequency. We call this discrete time Fourier transform. Okay, here also analog signal processing means input, output, both are continued time signals, y of t, x of t, and y of t. We call this analog signal processing. Okay, then the digital signal processing means analog to digital, we convert and we can get digital signal x of n, and we process and we produce, we make the digital signal to y of n. Then from digital to analog converter, finally we can get also these analog signals. Now here, the important is for this is discrete time signal to here convert. This is digital signal processing. Therefore, we need to focus on this discrete time Fourier transform. Okay, this is a discrete Fourier transform. This is a discrete time Fourier transform here. Discrete time signal here. This one. For this, okay, from the engineer point, viewpoint of engineer point. Now, there are two problems to implement this. First one is this one. This one. How can you handle this infinite number of x of n? This is one problem. The next problem is this is continuous 0 to 2 pi. Therefore, we need to change this one. Infinite to finite number of x n. Also continues to discrete omega. Okay, then we need to solutions. The solution from the viewpoint of engineer. Then we can implement by using this infinite number of n and continuous omega. We cannot implement this one. Okay, from this, how to omega infinity to n means very simple concept. We have dividing the continuous signal into block. We calculate block by block. This one, n samples. We can calculate n samples of discrete time Fourier transform while moving this. Like this one, the signal is, for example, 0 to infinity. And we blocked this, we've been doing this one, n samples. Like this one, here to here, we need n samples. This period, this length, we call this frame length, or window length, or window size. Now here, the interval in samples is T sampling period. Therefore, here to the length is nTs. We call this time resolution. And this window move to here and here like this. Okay, one example. For example, sample frequency equal 100. Then the number of samples here 100. Then time resolution means NTS equal NTS equal 1 by FS. Therefore, N equal 100 samples and 1 by FS 100. From this, we can get 1 Hertz. Therefore, in this case, time resolution is 1 second. And 1 second here. Okay, then next, how to convert continuous to discrete of omega like this one. Well, this is very simple concept. Now omega equal 0 to 2 pi. We can divide 2 pi by log n like this. 1 log this like this can get. Divide by n. Divide. Then, okay, then this is 0. This is 2 pi by n into 1, 2, 3, and k like this one. Here, we call this the frequency interval. Interval means 2 pi by n. Also, this corresponds to fs by n. We call this frequency resolution. Frequency resolution. Thus, we can replace omega by 2 pi by n k, like this is this omega. Okay. Then we can change e power minus a omega into e power minus 2 pi by n k, this. For this, for example here, fs equal 100, n equal 100, then frequency resolution means now fs by n means fs by n, fs equal 100, n equal 1, therefore 1 Hertz is frequency resolution, 1 Hertz. Okay, now here, like this, let me summarize. Okay, discrete time Fourier transform is here, and discrete Fourier transform is here. Now you said from this one, infinite number of xn, we can change n numbers of this one. Now here also, this omega continues to discrete, we can change. And also k equal 0, 1, 2, 3, and then minus 1. Here, the meaning of k is 2 pi by n k. That means fs by n, 2 pi corresponds to the fs, that we call this one. Therefore, k equal 1 means fs by 1 Hertz. K 2 means fs fs by n into 2 Hertz, like this. Now this meaning of k is very important. Then one, let me introduce one important property of x omega and x of k. First, x omega, you know, like this one. Instead of omega, substitute omega plus 2 pi, then here omega also 2 pi. Then we extend this one and this one. Now this is minus a 2 pi n. This is this is integer. Therefore, this always 1 means this is x omega. Therefore, x omega plus 2 pi equals to x omega. That means x omega is repeated by 2 pi. This is x omega is a periodical signal. This is. Also, discrete Fourier transform x of k also like this. Then instead of k, we can make k plus this period. Then this k instead of this one. And also, we expand this one, and this one. Now here, and cancelled. This is also equal 1. This means, then we call this x of k. Now here, x k plus n equals x of k. Now this x of k is repeated by n. Now this is also periodical, with the period of n, like this one. Okay, thank you so much for your watching. Today I have derived discrete Fourier transform from discrete time Fourier transform and introduced time resolution NTS and the frequency resolution 2 pi by n and fs or fs by n and introduced one property of DFT, this is periodical. Next, we need to, this is n is very important one. And how to change infinite to n? We call this the problem of window functions. Next lecture, I will introduce window functions. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you so much.